up, everybody? Welcome to the Ectoplasm Show. My name is Josh Hurd, and joining me is my good pal, partner in crime, Mr. Jason Kupsick. What the fuck is cracking, Playboy?
I am drinking your favorite beer again tonight.
Dick.
I'm drinking the Franklin Road Coffee Porter by Big Red Brewing Company.
Dick, man.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, it's good. It's amazing.
What are you drinking, Josh?
I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to talk about what I'm drinking.
So we have Brent Hand. Whenever I think of your name, I think of Dark City. Have you ever seen Dark City, the movie?
No, I always get Fast Times at Ridgemont High. Yeah. Is what people tell me. Mr. Hand.
Yeah. Oh, well, there's a Mr. Hand in Dark City as well. He's one of the weird aliens that control things.
I got that going for me.
So cool. Yeah, we have Brent Hand from Hysteria 51 podcast. Welcome to the Ectoplasm Show.
Thank you. And I'm drinking no one's favorite beer, Bud Light. So.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, that's what you're drinking every time, so I figured I might as well not ask.
I can hear the shame in your voice. It's okay.
Oh no, I drink Bud Light all the time. There's no problem with it. Actually, I haven't been drinking much lately because I've been on some pretty powerful pain meds and muscle relaxers. But I am gonna have a beer tonight. So
there you go.
Hopefully, nice. I wake up in the morning first time.
God. First round.
If not, first, yeah. Hang, I guess, right?
Yeah, you could take over for me, Brent.
I work cheap.
Just got to make these feet touch the floor, and we're going to try it.
All right, not only is our show brought to you by Big Rip, we are also now on the Pod Bros Podcast Network. Go check them out and say hi to all our friends like Language of Bromance. That's a show I've been listening to lately of theirs, and it's a great show.
Hell yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, go over and check those guys out for sure.
Excellent.
I think I'm fucking dying over here.
Man, it is the season. I've been sick for like 2 weeks, I feel like, so. And they did an article today. I live in Chicago, and it said Chicago is officially colder than Mars right now. So we got one thing to brag about.
It makes you feel good. Makes a guy feel good.
It's not get shot because everyone's staying indoors. So
yeah, crime rate's probably pretty low right now.
We're all safe.
I'm going to start out the show this week saying that call us at 913-730-7725 or text us. You can't send us pictures, which is actually sometimes probably a good thing, but you can email us a picture.
You could email us a picture, ectoplasmshow@gmail.com. You could do that.
Or you can find us anywhere on the social medias. Hey, Brent, why don't you tell our fine listeners where they could find you and your stuff before we get into the news?
You can find us on Twitter at Hysteria51Pod or at Facebook.com/Hysteria51Pod. We also got our own website, Hysteria51.com.
So which one of you is the brains behind the podcast?
You know what? It was John, my co-host's idea to come up with the podcast. I'm the one who does all the editing. So I think I'm his bitch, I guess would be the best thing to say. we share everything pretty much 50-50. It was his idea to do it. And I jumped at the chance. We're only about, I think we just had our 13th episode. So we haven't done a ton. We're still pretty new, a few months, but having a blast.
I think I've been listening since the first one.
Yeah. It's funny to, you listen in those few that we've done, how far you come from, you know, episode one to episode 13. I listened to the first couple. I'm like, oh my God. We have a couple we didn't release. And I think when we get to 20, maybe we'll pump a couple of those out just so people can make fun of us.
Yeah. I came along at number 30 on the Ectoplasm Show. And before that, it was a shit show.
Thanks a lot, pal.
I came in to save Josh.
Here he comes on his fucking white horse.
I'll take over from here, boys.
Yeah, exactly. I got this. You with your fucking pleasing baritone voice and all that horse
shit. Yeah. It's my most complimented feature. by far, because most of them can't see this beautiful face and long, luxurious locks I got going on right now.
either podcast host or sex phone worker.
And yeah, exactly.
Receiver, so. Well, there's no laws stating that I can't be both.
That is true. You're a double threat, as they call it, I guess.
If you could only see me.
Whatever pays the bills, right, pal? Oh, my God, I love it.
I can't work on my back, though, because my back is currently falling apart.
Hence need a back.
Hence the pain meds and shit. So, anyways. Nope. I got a weird story for you.
I want to hear it.
Frozen woman, quote, frozen woman fiasco unfolds in New York.
Frozen woman?
Yeah, this comes from Coast to Coast via ABC News. I'll just read the story real quick and we'll get into it. What looked to be either an incredible rescue or an unimaginable tragedy turned into a full-blown farce for police in Hudson, New York, when they smashed into a car to ostensibly save a dying woman. The weird incident began with a frantic call from a woman saying that she had spotted an elderly woman who had frozen to death in the front seat of a car. When officers arrived on the scene, they saw the distressed senior inside the car, and she was wearing an oxygen mask and appeared unresponsive. Realizing that the car had been parked overnight, the cops began imagining the worst and set about the grim task of extracting the frozen woman from the vehicle. However, after they smashed a window in the back seat of the car and gained access to the vehicle, the officers realized that the frozen woman was, in fact, an incredibly realistic mannequin.
What?
Ironically, when the owner of the car arrived to retrieve it, he revealed that the doll has a bit of a life-saving experience herself in that she is a specially designed mannequin for CPR classes.
Oh.
As a sales manager for the company that makes the device, the man claimed that he drives with the lifeless woman in the passenger seat of the car and even has her wear a seatbelt.
Wow.
He states that it's because of the fragility of the doll, but they suppose that he probably just uses it to take the carpool lane, yeah.
Man.
So we've all heard about the dog getting locked in the car, the kid getting locked in the car during the heat. This thing was real enough that it fooled the police officers. They showed pictures of it. I mean, that's it looked realer than, like, those real sex dolls.
Listen to you.
So, last summer, my wife and I are at our local zoo, and there's a guy pushing a woman in a wheelchair right in front of us, and he's going to the bathroom, and we kind of walk around him, and I hear him say to her, "Hey, baby, I'm going to go in the bathroom. I'll be right back." As I pass, I look, and it is a honest to God one of those like $5,000 real sex dolls in a wheelchair. I come out of the bathroom. He's in there. My wife's like, "Oh my God, did you see that?" I shit you not. We go home that day, and I look it up. This guy is like quasi-famous in Chicago. He's been on like the Maury Povich show and all this stuff because he's married to this sex doll, pays for her to get into like movies and shit, and she's his wife.
Wow.
Hey, you know, you never know what you're going to see. But that it was fucked up. And she's got a stuffed like panda bear on her lap. Like he'd went to the gift shop and be like, "Pick some now, baby."
Anything you like, sweetie.
Well, I would have to guess that the divorce rate between people and their sex dolls is pretty low.
she might not pull her weight, but she doesn't talk back. So, yeah, I hear you.
Oh, my God. That's great.
So who pays for the broken window? Yeah. The 911, the caller? Like, I don't get it.
Yeah, who's that fall on?
I'm guessing it's probably the company's insurance. Well, he's just a sales rep. He's got to have some kind of business insurance, though. Yeah. His own damn fault, really.
Oh, my gosh.
What do you got, Josh? You got a story this week?
Nothing that fucking good. Nothing that cool. Now I feel shitty. It says the world's largest cloning facility is now ready to replicate humans.
Nothing bad can happen with that.
No, fuck no. Like, it should be fine. The Boya Life Corporation is ready to venture away from cloning animal species like cows, racehorses, and pet/police dogs. So a scientist is ready to take on his next big overture, cloning humans. The only problem is that the ethical reasons could cause a public uproar and disgust. As a consumer, it is easy to... Grocery store, it says, and you'll see the cloned strawberries and bananas and all that bullshit. Crazy. It says, with cloning, it brings several ethical questions to mind. So, if before somebody dies, for example, could you clone them so that with, you know, future technology, you could then bring that person back to life? It may mean that in the future, death as we know it would take on, you know, a different definition entirely. So humans will be more likely to accept the research from these companies if there's tangible results for them. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
I mean, it's crazy to think about. But, I mean, think about another thing that I was reading here. Cloning would also allow, you know, same-sex couples the opportunity to perhaps create a child using their own DNA. Do you see what I'm getting
at? I understand that, but haven't they already created a child from three different people?
I have sworn I saw that story a year ago.
You don't know what that is. I don't know if it's, like, widespread, but they've at least are saying that they can do that now.
Right. So, I mean, the main, like, goal and purpose here is this would allow, like, people with, like, Alzheimer's, AIDS, cancer, things like that, Parkinson's, you know.
I've seen this. This is a movie. It has Arnold Schwarzenegger in it. It's called The Sixth Day.
I have never heard of it.
Or was that one, The Island, where they made all the clones?
The Island. That's a good one.
Yeah.
So basically, like, science fiction may be fast becoming science fact here. I don't know. I don't know if this is actually going to happen, if this is ever going to, like, come to fruition, or
the thing about science smoke is here. The government is always 25 to 30 years ahead. They're Absolutely. Already doing this shit, probably.
So what are they cloning?
They're cloning people to make up our secret space program.
Same fucking people.
All those people that got to airbrush out of those Mars pictures. Just clones.
There is a lot of that shit. Or they say there's a lot of that shit.
Yeah, right?
Oh, my goodness.
I don't know, man. I wouldn't want to be the guinea pig. Well, I guess it wouldn't matter. Be me, but I wouldn't want my clone to be the guinea pig.
The thing about cloning is it's not really you. I mean, you can make an argument that it is, but that's the old argument, I guess.
To transfer your conscience somehow, or
just it. That's where I'm getting at now. Your conscience is your soul, so to speak, like, is not there. This is something entirely different. Meaning, personality could be completely different, or what have you. All the bits and pieces that make you, you, would be gone.
Right.
All you have then is just somebody that fucking looks like you.
Yeah, that you can harvest for organs. So, yeah, perfect.
Sex dolls.
Thanks, buddy.
The really realistic sex dolls.
Well, yeah, then you can plan and have it exactly like you want it.
Yeah. Yeah. We've had a run on name whatever actress this month. Like I don't think I want to keep being this guy's. Go back to the contract.
Yeah right.
Send the hate mail, the feminist hate mail, to @hysteria51 on Twitter.
Yes, right.
We're running short on the Mila Kunis over here.
Yeah. Crank up the ovens, boys.
Damn it. We just got an order for 20 more Julia Robertses over here. I don't know what's going on.
I don't know if we have enough face for that.
Oh, my goodness. Fun stuff.
So let's see what Mr. Brett Hand brought to the episode this week.
Oh, yeah.
Staying with the whole sex vibe that we're going this place, the Spiritual Science Research Foundation, just came out with an article that said 85% of all gay men aren't really gay. They're just possessed by female ghosts that cause them to have attractions towards men.
Wow.
They published these findings in a what I can only believe is a heavily peer-reviewed article online. And it kind of got traction all of the news as of late. This is the ghost consciences overpower the person's normal behavior to produce the homosexual attraction, the group wrote on their website. They cite spiritual research as proving that the cause for homosexual preferences lie predominantly in the spiritual realm. So only 5% of gay people are actually gay, they say. 85% are ghosts and the rest are whatever they're claiming.
Wow.
Yeah.
It sounds that like is... somebody is questioning their own sexuality.
Yeah, like, I can't be gay. I must be possessed. It's the only logical explanation.
I wonder how they came up with the test to find out that it's actually 5%.
Right? Yeah. Like, it says 5% of gay people are gay due to hormonal changes. 10% are considered gay because they had an experience with a person of the same sex as a teenager or a young adult that was pleasurable and therefore wanting to experience again, but they're not actually gay.
Wow.
That's a quote.
Wow.
So ghosts, pulling double duty. They got all sorts of jobs, man. You know, you never know. And lesbians, it said they actually asked these people, like, lesbians, same thing, 85%, same thing.
Same thing.
Yep, it's just across the boards. The Spiritual Science Research Foundation, who I'm sure has droves and droves of followers and,
funding. I bet they have a class coming near you, Josh, and you can go meet up for the show and learn some stuff.
We'll get that. We'll get that interview.
We'll get on site. Oh, you know who wants to be our roaming reporter is Mr. Eric Ensbrenner of Atchison Paranormal. If I find anything like that here in town, I'm sending him to go investigate them.
Yes, I think that that's a grand idea.
Oh, but you know, if they sent the Catholic Church in to do an exorcism, it would be fabulous. Can you imagine watching throwing the holy water?
Now, what about
they're not cute enough, and now they're just possessed. You know, so
we got to do something about these lights. It's all wrong. All wrong in here.
So, I told you, I mentioned to you, Brent, in Messenger earlier that I saw a guy online that can hook you up with a demon. Teach you how to have a sexual interaction with the demon. I think that's something we should have Eric do. That's definitely Eric's first assignment.
Is get donked by a demon?
Well, no, him to go take this course or whatever and try it out. And if it happens, it happens, you know.
You go on, like, demonsonly.com or, like, access
don't have to be lonely at demonsonly.com. Set up now, motherfucker.
And then they just play the entire thing again in reverse.
Speaking of that, and I'm gonna mention it because he won't hear it, and I don't think he would care anyways. My neighbor has become super, super religious over the last couple months, and we were out by the fire in my backyard 2 weeks ago, and Tyson was over here.
Oh yeah.
And he came over. My neighbor came over and started, like, going on and on and on about this reverse stuff in metal music, how it's all evil, but it's only metal music, it's not other music. And it was just threw me through a loop, because this was the guy that was smoking pot in my back room and getting drunk every night not too long ago.
Interesting.
It's always the people that are the furthest towards the fringe that are grasping for any straw that they can get at, whether it be religion, drugs, sex, whatever. Like, those are the people, no matter what they're into, they got to tell you about it and you're missing out. It doesn't matter. My wife, one of her friends from school, I probably shouldn't even say this, but her dad was like this big stoner pothead. And then he turned into like a preacher. And then next thing you know, he's, you know, damn the church and he's a pothead again. And then he's a, you know, like an exterminator. And no matter what he's doing, that's what you need to be doing. And this is the right path. And yeah, wow. Those people, and they're the first people that corner you at a party when you don't know anyone. And like, I'm going to talk to you for 45 minutes about shit you do not care about.
Speaking of shit, I want to ask you about one of your other friends that you mentioned on the show today that craps his pants twice a year, and it's just okay and normal for him.
Twice in one night, he shit his pants. Yeah, like in one night, just stood up to blow out a candle, crapped his pants. You know what? When he did that, he went inside, threw his clothes away, went and took a shower, and he comes back out. He tells his wife, I threw my clothes away. She goes to dig his clothes out of the trash to wash them. Sits back down, goes to relight the candle, craps his pants again, passes her on the way in. She's coming back out. He's like, I did it again, baby.
Yeah, you mentioned he does it like twice a year, and it just seems normal to him.
Yeah, he's like, you know, like, he doesn't, like my wife said, he's over 3 and under 60, so he doesn't have a lot of excuses other than, I don't know, man.
Oh, my God, that's great, though. I can just imagine like his wife like fucking trying to dig out his freshly beshitted pants and
wash them. And she just has that thousand yard stare, you know, because she's got to deal with it all
the
time.
You need to check him for some sort of demon.
No
shit. It's like
I do
the gold
have something
Gotham.
Yeah, the Golgothan, yeah.
I do have a story about something that might help with that. Well,
the shit demon?
The headline is Ghost Repellent. New device allegedly blasts unwanted paranormal entities out of your home. This comes from weekendweird.com. It says there's no shortage of fascinating ghost hunting technology on the market today. Whether you're looking to see invisible spirits, hear their voices, or even communicate with them, there's a good chance that some mad scientist out there has a gadget that claims to do just that. But for those who are less interested in communicating with spirits as much as banishing them, they're usually stuck doing things the old-fashioned way with holy water or sage. Well, the days of relying on biological exorcists are over. A new device claims it will blast the phantoms from your home. The quote, wave killer technology.
Of course.
Yeah.
The Thai company Super Boondi has released a brand new version of the Trisakshi Ghost Repellent. This isn't the first iteration. This is actually the second one. A device with the design straight out of Ghostbusters, which the company claims will rid your residents of unwanted spirits thanks to this specially designed circuitry. So how does it work? Well, when you're ready to clear your home of negative entities, you simply switch on the flip the switch on the ghost repellent box, which activates a low-level electromagnetic field, condenser microphone, and infrared camera that work in unison to detect paranormal activity. Super Boondi calls this the phenomenon receptor. When the machine detects an anomaly, it automatically fires off a wave killer radio blast that they claim is enough to force the nasty phantom to abandon the chosen haunt. Much like those sonic rodent repellents, the box will simply continue to drive off ghosts no matter how many times they attempt to return. So what do you think? The thing looks like a speaker without the carpet around it, which is like a little hole in the middle, and the circuitry inside looks like it was made in the 80s.
Nice.
Thailand?
Yeah, Thailand company. Super Boondi is the name of the company. That's Boondee.
They take their ghosts and stuff serious over there. Like,
yeah,
it's just to them, it's not like a something that you laugh at. They think it's absolutely just part of life, like ghosts and stuff like that. It sounds just like some company absolutely trying to capitalize on that.
It said they've made their first one in 2009. But they got, the media really got after them on it, so they decided not to mass produce it. apparently they make other stuff, but it doesn't say what on here. They sell those on eBay. And
yeah, this I'm looking at it right now. It's like
it
very
$1,500 plus the extra $140 for overseas shipping. That's how much it costs. $1,640. Yeah. Keep that demon away from your crotch.
Keep away from your crotch.
What was that called? You said spectrophilia? Is that what it's called?
Spectrophilia, yes. It's a wonderful thing. Wonderful thing. It's the wave of the future.
Where do I sign up?
Right.
They do have a schematic, so maybe you could build your own.
I saw that, too. The super boondie.
For the hand-painted person, yeah.
Do you think $1,600 is worth it?
I'd probably rather just stick with the ghost.
We need to find somebody that has the money to buy one of these.
You guys need to set up a Patreon just for this so you guys can order yourself one.
Who wants to give us $1,600?
We'll let you stare at a camera that's pointed at the box 24 hours a day if you help us pay for it.
Tell us if it's working or not.
Yeah. You know, I haven't had any ghosts in my house since we bought this. I hadn't had any beforehand either, but, you know, I guess it's working. I don't know.
Worth every penny.
I want to see those commercials for it on the TV over there, because all their commercials are so over the top with random English words thrown in, like Zang Super Boondi.
That's not a thing, we need to make that a thing.
We could easily do this
YouTube video.
Maybe they
could
become a sponsor and you guys get one for free.
That's a great idea.
Yeah. Bring it over to the American market. You guys are guinea pig the tests for them.
I would love that.
Time to whip out an email.
Yeah, right? I'm going to compose this son of a bitch right now.
That's it for the show this evening.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Oh, my goodness.
What do you got, Josh?
All right. So this actually has like a video attached with it, so I'm going to have to post that. But this actually comes from our good buddies over at ParanormalWarehouse.com. I saw they had posted this, and I found it interesting because it's about a haunted pub. Let's see. I don't want to do that. So manager Kate Ann Round and her fiancé Ben Parks come to check out a wet floor sign in this video that's clearly being pushed by something that isn't there in the video. When Parks goes to investigate, the mop then falls from the wall onto the floor, freaking the shit out of this poor guy, and he runs away. It says, customers have long since complained of paranormal activities going down at the Chapel House, and when you look into the pub's past, it gets even worse. Duh, duh, duh. So, it says, ages ago, the locale's cellar was used to store criminals, as it was once used as a police station. The ghosts of angry inmates and ne'er-do-wells may be lurking around the Chapel House, or just a bunch of people who really, really like to drink and pull pranks on people. The trouble with ghosts is you just never know. Ha ha ha. But crazy
stuff.
I've
seen the video.
Wait, hold on. Did you see the video?
I've seen the video. It's been out for a couple weeks now. And
right.
I'll get to that in a minute. First, I do want to comment on one thing. I am so tired of everything being so scary and dark. And also, that everybody tries to make themselves look like a mafia enforcer in their paranormal pictures, group pictures. But that's just my opinion. As far as the picture, the video,
hey,
it's a couple
you.
Things falling over. And if I had captured it and known that there was nothing tied to it, then maybe, you know, I'd be impressed by it. But it looks a lot like a lot of the videos where people make stuff happen in them. What are you freaking out about over there?
I'll be right back.
Okay.
Right back, I swear.
That's the problem. It's just the skepticism in so many of those videos. You're right. You said if it didn't happen to you, it's going to be hard to believe. And so many of them just look so set up.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's how, I mean, that's how I feel in this entire field. And that's what I tell everybody. Like, Josh, I've known for a long time. And he could show me something, and I'll believe Josh because I trust him. But I still wasn't there, so I don't know.
Yeah. And people that you do know, even if you did see something and you want to talk to them, people are still skeptical, and that's people you know. So it's a hard sell, you know, to the... Or there's also the people that no matter what you say, they're just blindly believe in anything. And those are the people that watch most of the TV shows on television with ghost hunters, which I feel half of those are just bullshit and schlock. So
yeah, they most likely are. And you're wrong about the amount. The highest demographic for ghost adventures is 14 to 18 year old girls.
Oh, wow.
Because of Zach.
Yeah.
He's a douche.
He's so dreamy.
I've never watched that show. I've watched one episode. So what happened, Josh?
Never been so scared in my entire life.
Yeah?
So where I sit in my office, I can actually
see... I don't
believe that. No, look. Like, I can see down onto the first level of the house. So I have a stairwell right here. And then I can see down into the first level of the house, which is the toy room area. So as we're talking about spooky, weird shit at this pub in England, there was three stuffed animals that flew off the shelf. That wasn't what caught my attention, right? Which, like, coming up here, like, I'm a kind of a dick dad, and so I always make my kids pick up their shit because
That's
I don't want
to admit it.
Yeah, I'm just kind of a dick. But anyway, three of those sons of bitches are on the floor, right? One of them then, as I'm going down the steps to go see what the fuck is going on, starts playing this fucking song, Jesus Loves Me, right?
So it's not terrifying in the slightest.
Not at all. I don't want to be in this house right now.
You know, our fan, I don't remember who it was, but the guy that left the most recent iTunes review is right about you. You are such a pansy.
See, I'm a big old pussy. Yeah, that's it. Now, in my own defense, though, dickweed, I went down the damn steps. I checked out what was going on. It scared the shit out of me, and I'm still doing the show.
Well, we got strength in numbers here. You can look at the screen and see our pictures.
Strength
well,
in numbers. Okay, please.
Somewhat in pictures, but...
You know what you need?
Have you seen...
That's what you need.
Brent, can you see his profile picture?
Yeah.
I put up crazy profile pictures every time.
There's nothing comforting about your profile picture.
Well, at least somebody will be a witness to what happens to you.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
And
there
I'm recording go. As well, so everybody will at least still be able to see it or hear it.
Jesus God.
Where were
just
we?
Background and hear you screaming, but yeah, you know. We'll still hear it.
Hey, like, yeah. That's usually what I say. I'm screaming, it's usually a lot of F-bombs.
I'm sure he's fine. Just keep going.
Fine. Josh does this.
You know, some point, though, I'm going to see something behind you, and you're not going to believe me when I try to point it out.
Because everybody's like, what's that behind Josh? What is that behind Josh? I'm like, oh, ha, 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 guys. This is horseshit.
Have you calmed down now?
Fine.
Now every time you look to the side, I'm waiting for something.
Yeah, right? God. All right.
All right, Brent, you got another story?
Speaking of haunted houses, so here in Illinois, there's this place called the Roth Home. It is in Watseka, Illinois, the Watseka Wonder. You ever heard of it?
Yeah, I've heard of this place.
Yeah, so it was, they call it the America's first documented spiritual possession. 1800s. This woman was supposedly possessed by Mary Roth, and the house has been shut down for, you know, tours and anything like that, and they needed renovations. So actually this month they're reopening it to ghost hunters, paranormal places, stuff like that, to go through it. And it's been on Unsolved Mysteries and all those kind of shows. And I guess the foundation was like cracking, and they didn't want to lose a house. So They're letting other shows come back in to do investigations starting this month for a couple months, just to pump in some funds to help with it. ROFF House or ROFF Home. And it's pretty neat. It's got a, if you go to YouTube, you can watch tons of videos of people that have done seances and Ouija boards and interviews in there. And it's a crazy house, man. The woman supposedly that was Lorenzi was the woman who was supposedly possessed. She lived in another home and she was possessed by this woman named Mary Roth. She moved into the Roth home and knew like the family and the friends and the woman's life. And it lasted for a few months and then no longer possessed. And she went back home. So crazy, crazy story. And hopefully they make their money back, you know, because hey, it's Illinois. It's close to me. And that's kind of fun.
Why doesn't Hysteria 51 do an live investigation, recorded investigation there?
We are talking about that. John's getting in touch with them. So we want to do that. And there's actually a pub here that's supposedly in Berwyn where I live that is haunted, and they do tours like once a year. So we're going to do that and have a live event there too.
Well,
so.
I will give you the grace of my presence if you book a flight for me. I'll come
yeah.
up.
Yeah.
Not that bad of a drive.
No.
Yeah. I don't. How far is it?
From Kansas City, I think it's about 8-9 hours.
Yeah. I had a buddy who just went to Kansas City this weekend, so not terrible. Not terrible.
No. Or you could fly it for 45 minutes.
yeah, right? True. Get you on the Spirit Airlines or whatever it is when they do those, like, $39 deer.
Oh, shit.
So, what's the temperature there, Brent?
It's been, today I think it was -7.
Nice.
We get what they call lake effect because we're right next to Lake Michigan. Yeah. So it all the wind and everything, and it's just terrible.
So, yeah it's like 20 here. Unless you're planning on going to Florida next week, we can all hate on Josh because he'll be in sunny Florida next week, sunning himself.
Sorry.
I'll be here a couple weeks. My wife's going to Jamaica with her. So I'm hating on her while I'm stuck here, but... No Florida or Jamaica for me.
Yeah, so we'll be taking next week off. Everybody will have to make do with old episodes.
We are going to have to, take the week off.
But I have a fun story here.
All right, hit it.
When he saw a Ouija board, he went psycho, stabbed girlfriend, police says.
Holy fuck.
This comes from MLive.com, which is Michigan Live, one of their news websites. Bay City, Michigan. Police are alleging a 23-year-old man was upset over the presence of a Ouija board to the degree that he headbutted and stabbed his girlfriend.
Police. I don't want that evil in my house. Stab, stab, stab.
So
stab.
Either this was after a really late night, which is probably the case. Police at 7:36 a.m. on Friday, December 9th, responded to the emergency room at McLaren Bay Region Hospital to investigate a reported stabbing. The victim, 22-year-old Crystal A. Wallfelt, was wearing an oxygen mask and told officers she had fallen in a barn in Essexville, court's reports show. Hospital staff told police she had a stab wound on her back under her right arm, causing her to suffer a collapsed lung. Police Damn. Went on to interview two females and two males, all in their 20s, who had brought the woman to the hospital. All four said they had witnessed her boyfriend, Cody T. Sampson, that sounds like a winner, stab her inside her apartment in the Tradewinds East Complex in Hampton Township. One of the witnesses said they were playing a Ouija board because the house is haunted, in which Samson allegedly had a problem. He went all psycho and started to take the board away from me, but I told him to bring it back because it wasn't mine, the witness said. She put the game away, but Samson and Wallfelt proceeded to argue, to the point that he headbutted her, pulled out a folding knife, and stabbed her. So he had to unfold it. So he wasn't like... I mean, it could have been a fit of rage still, but... He took the time to unfold his knife.
Sounds like a lot of work.
The other three witnesses gave a similar account, adding that Samson said he was going to kill her. The four friends separated Samson and his girlfriend. So yeah, he walked in, saw that they were playing, and freaked out because, quote, that's a game for Satan worshipers.
I'm here, let me kill you.
Yeah. So he's, you know, he's of normal mental health and nothing.
In, sees them playing this game and goes caca duty shit crazy.
Yeah, and his picture, like, we'll post all these links and stuff when the show comes out, but
I'm sure
he looks like
picture,
a winner, just like
the
his name.
From his graduation for his master's degree or something like that. it's the only one they could find.
That's right.
He makes the Aurora shooter look kind of normal.
Oh, man.
So, yeah, there may have been drugs involved. They don't say that in here. They probably would have tested it for it. They're seeking a $150,000 cash bond. And, oh, the lawyers are trying to get a more reasonable bond for the guy.
I think that is way too low if you're stabbing people for board games because you think that they're evil. Let's you know, let's revoke bond on that one for a little while. Let's think this out. I don't know.
Oh, like, yeah, this about Parker Brothers.
This winner was already due to be arraigned in court on January 18th for domestic violence against his father as well.
Jeez, man. What are we doing,
dude?
Guy?
See that. I didn't see that part at the bottom down there, but
jeez.
But you know that some, like, I went to the actual source page. I pulled what was on Coast to Coast, and it didn't mention half this stuff. Somebody's going to run with this and claim that it was the board that made him stab her. I bet lots of people are running with it.
Yeah, of course they are. That's the easiest go-to. Like, well, you know, it'll be, I'm sure who's going to run with it is his lawyer. That's going to be the defense, or at least or something they're going to try. of course they're going to be like, and what happened with your father? Oh, you know. Monopoly possession.
Yeah, that reminds me, there was a story on Coast to Coast. I don't know why it was on Coast to Coast. That in Europe, in England specifically, they have a special line set up for people playing Monopoly that get in fights to call and mediate the game for the holidays, because so many people apparently get in fights playing Monopoly during the holidays over there.
You know how many times that fucking thimble has been thrown at my face? I know what's up. Yeah.
My wife and I, we played board games one time. I had never played Risk in my life. We were married. We were living together. She's like, oh, you want to play Risk? I think we went and got board games from her parents' house. I'm like, sure. And I didn't know how to play. And she explained the rules to me. About an hour and a half in, I'm winning. And she's like, fuck this game. Fine, we're quitting. 6 months later, we're getting a new couch, and she's like cleaning out under the couch, and there's like two of the little Risk guys that were mine. She's like, I knew you cheated. Like, this is your color, you cheating assholes. Like, it brings out the worst in people, or the best. Or maybe I was cheating. I don't know. She made the rules up, though. So
I don't play board games hardly anymore. We'll play card games, but board games, I've just won too many times. Actually, they say that I cheat, which is not true. I have a Trivial Pursuit game. If I play it more than a couple times a year, I'll remember the cards. That's how I got through high school. I never did my homework or anything. I just remembered what the teacher said and passed all the tests.
Yeah.
So if I play Trivial Pursuit, if I had played it within the last few months, I will remember every single card that I had just by the question. So it pisses people off.
Yeah.
Well, and we bought my wife and I bought Connect Four once for my daughter years ago.
It's a fun game.
We played it before we gave it to her for Christmas. We played 9 games. I won 9 times, and I never played again with her.
This one, you got to play games like Cards Against Humanity or something where there's no like clear. I mean, you're just making it up, you know. So
yeah,
I don't know, because people love to argue. It brings out competition, brings the worst out in people, or the best, but usually the worst.
Usually it's the worst, yeah.
You know,
yes,
it's not my fault. I'm good.
That damn Ouija board,
right?
That's a game I probably wouldn't get accused of cheating at. Except for well, you're moving it.
You're moving in.
You move the planchette. I saw you do it.
Gosh. That's fun, my friend. So, out of curiosity,
did you pull one?
You didn't find anything.
No, I didn't look. I decided to start early. I am tired of me and Mr. Doom and Gloom. 2017 is going to be different. Unless there's a noteworthy way we're going to die, I'm not going to pull a killer story every week.
Like how we're going to die?
Yeah.
I'm a little upset about
this. If people don't like it, they could email me and let me know.
I'm sure it'll be fine. It'll be fine.
Nobody even noticed that I didn't do one last week.
I noticed.
Yeah. So, yeah, every week I pull the world's going to end. This is how the world's going to end. We're all going to die story. It spawned because there was a period in my life of like 5 years where I didn't remember a single dream except for when the world ended. I had hundreds of them. Hundreds of them. So I started talking about that, and then I came, well, I'm going to tell everybody how they're going to die every week, and I'm tired of scaring people.
I worked with a guy who thought that the Yellowstone supervolcano was going to erupt at any time.
It could. It could, actually.
It could. And so it was about 3 years ago, I think, when the bison all left the park, mm-hmm. like, at once. Like, they were just, like, migrating out. And people were like, well, that's weird. He took off work. And he called and he's like, they're like, what are you doing? Why are you taking tomorrow off? He's like, I'm drinking margaritas all day long because we're all going to die.
Like, that's it.
And we didn't die. So, you know.
Wow. Did he keep his job?
Oh, no, yeah. I mean, he took the vacation day. You know, he's just okay. Like, I'm taking the day off and going to drink margaritas because we're all going to be dead.
I want an end-of-the-world day.
Yeah,
I don't have a job right now anyways, so every day is end-of-the-world day for me.
Right?
Every day.
I guess it is kind of crazy, though, if, like, you're going into, like, a national park and all the animals are just passing you going the other way. That is slightly alarming.
I remember that exact story, that exact time, because I pay attention to stuff like that.
Well, and it made all the rounds and all the doomsday preppers mm-hmm. and stuff like that is, here it comes. You know, there's a lot of people that are going like, yes, I knew I was right. You know, they get excited and,
well, it's way overdue. That doesn't mean it's going to happen anytime soon, but it is about 60,000 years overdue.
Yep.
But I did see a story that over the last like week and a half or 2 weeks, there's been 180 micro earthquakes in Mount St. Helens, and they think it might be building to blow again.
Yeah. What was that? When did that blow last?
1980. It seems like it was in my lifetime, which I was born in 82, but it wasn't. It was 2 years before I was born.
I remember. I don't remember it, but I remember like the story of, you know. So yeah. Another thing with going back to Yellowstone, have you seen where in like the last few weeks or a few months, like two people have fallen in the pools,
yes.
and they just like melt because they're so hot and the water, you know. They just literally melt. One of them, they fell in and they're like, oh, we'll fish out the remains the next day. Gone, completely eaten away.
Yeah, it's the different chemical compounds and stuff in there. The acidity actually physically eats them. It's like a actual really strong acid, like a Breaking Bad acid.
Yeah. Stronger than the Jeffrey Dahmer blue bucket of acid that he was stewing people in his apartment.
The blue bucket of acid.
You remember that? Do you remember that? Where they literally had like a 55-gallon drum of acid. He was dissolving bodies in his house.
We had a doctor here in Kansas City. I don't even remember his name, but he had, I think he was a doctor. I'm pretty good at remembering details. Yeah. It was like 10 years ago. They found like 20 blue of the like big blue rain bucket barrels, like the big ones.
Yeah.
With bodies in each one with acid.
Man.
I don't remember his name.
Everyone needs a hobby.
Yeah, I guess.
Everyone has a collection. Some are weirder than others. I don't know. What do you collect, Ted? Oh, you know, things.
Oh, just stuffing things.
Yeah. Come over, I'll show you.
Yeah. Curiosity. Gotta love it. Oh, my goodness.
Well, this was a fun episode.
It was, Ben.
Yeah.
It really was.
Yeah. Thanks for letting me be a part of it.
Thanks for coming on. And I'm going to be on your show months into next year.
Yeah. Which topic are we doing?
I picked the Yeti one.
Yeti.
Are you only going to talk about Yeti, or are you going to talk about all, like, Bigfoot in general?
So, I don't know. John had put Yeti and Abominable Snowman. I don't know if he's separating it from Bigfoot. I'll let you know. I think we could do them all in one, just all-encompassing, you know?
Well, there's literally hundreds of different supposed ones. I didn't know if you were just going to stick to, like, the
Jersey Devil and
Well, I didn't know if you're going to stick the Yeti in our field. Well, you're in the field now, too, but I know you guys are just kind of getting into it. The Yeti is reserved for, like, Siberia and Russia.
Yeah, I think is why he was. I think that's what he was going to do, but I didn't know if we were doing Bigfoot separately. But, okay. So maybe we're just doing...
Regardless.
The snow beasts, or whatever you want to call them, yeah. Which is me, pretty my fat ass in Chicago right now, because it's
they made them in clay all the way back in who knows when for that Santa Christmas reindeer special, Rudolph special. So
that's right.
It's like he's been around forever.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for sure.
Good. Old Abominable.
Oh, well, why don't you let everybody know again how to find you?
Yeah, we're at Hysteria 51 Pod and Facebook at Hysteria 51 Pod. You can email us or find all of our social media through our webpage, hysteria51.com. Check us out. And we're always on Twitter posting something stupid or retweeting other shows. So just something we were fans of forever. We loved listening to them. We're like, hey, let's take a crack at it. You know, I'm more the believer. My co-host is more the skeptic on everything. So sometimes he just sounds dumb, and I let him know. You know, it's fun. I'm sure you guys never fight. It's normal, you know.
Our little lover spat.
No, Josh knows that I'm usually right.
You're fucking always right. It's because you're like this walking fucking encyclopedia, and it pisses me off. Like, you're never wrong. I'm going to get you.
Hence why I always win a Trivial Pursuit, because I remember everything. It just, like, it's, I don't even know where it's at. It's, like, stored somewhere. It's something triggers the facts. They just spew out.
Yeah, but you're good at it. You're good at it.
I'd love to fill my head with, like, facts instead of horrible 80s movies quotes and stupid shit like that, you know?
Brent, but, you and I are in the same boat, my friend. Yeah, I'm just throwing it up there. Like, I can't even fucking remember waking up this morning, okay? And here's Koopsik. Like, you know, 12 years ago, I read this fucking article, and it said exactly this. And it's, like, verbatim what the damn article said.
Well, I also have the deep voice.
Remember? Yeah.
And the hairy body. No, I don't really have that. That's just what you guys are looking at. I'm actually pretty smooth. I'm pretty hairless.
Stop it.
You're training me. I understand.
Killing me over here. What are you doing to me, man? Goodness gracious.
Call us at 913-730-7255.
That's right. Ectoplasmshow at gmail.com, at ectoplasmshow on Instagram and Twitter, ectoplasmshow on Facebook, and ectoplasmshow.com. Rate and review us on iTunes. Check us out on YouTube.
All yes, that once fun. We reach 50 reviews, it needs to be reviews as well, not just ratings, on iTunes, I will give away a full spectrum camcorder, actually, as well as Ecto gear. We're at 15, so we have a ways to go unless everybody gets out there and puts some down.
Yeah, no, that's awesome, though.
It'll be fun. That'll be fun.
I modify them myself and sell them. If you want to buy one and not wait to win one, just let me know. Contact me.
Get a hold of the Koopsik.
The Koopsik.
That's fun.
Hell yes. All right, well, you guys... take it easy. Have a great rest of your week. Keep on trucking through, and we will talk to you again on Friday morning. Peace out. Cub Scout.